It's almost every child's dream to go from the blacktop to the bright lights of Madison Square Garden. Tonight, the city game is awash with contrasting styles as the Cardinal from Silicon Valley and the Pac-12 clash with the Gophers from the Land of Lakes and the Big Ten. Finally, an invitation to a dream fulfilled. To the Mecca of college basketball, Madison Square Garden in New York City for the championship game of the NIT. And you will see Minnesota take on Stanford. Minnesota played all three games on the road, becoming only the fifth team to make it New York after winning in such a fashion. In the first round, they knocked off LaSalle. In the second round, easily took care of Miami 78-60, then overcame a tough Middle Tennessee State team to advance to the city. It took overtime in the semis, but the Gophers knocked off Washington to move on to the championship. Stanford enjoyed a home court advantage throughout on their way to New York. The first round over Cleveland State, the second round in overtime over Illinois State. No problems in their quarterfinal as they easily handled Nevada. And then they cruised over a young UMass team and continued their march to the championship game. Good evening, everybody. Mike Patrick, Fran Fraschilla, Bill Raftery. It's great to have you with us. Minnesota is a team that somehow is just finding a way in this stage of the season. Fran, either they're overcoming multiple injuries or they're winning all these games in overtime.
Absolutely, and I think it's going to help this young team. They lost Trevor Mbakwe early in the year, one of the best players in the Big Ten. They've responded well, winning 6 of 7, something to build on for next season for Tubby.
Bill, Stanford comes into this game maybe playing their best basketball the entire year.
They're getting up and down. More possessions, more opportunities on the offensive end. Drive, draw, and kick. They're playing like Johnny Dawkins.
Our one-on-one tonight, the old real estate action.
Absolutely.
Location, location, location.
You're right, Mike. Of course, it's typical Big Ten basketball for the Minnesota Gophers. They get it done in the paint. And you talk about getting it done. It's Rodney Williams, the junior, 58 dunks on the season. 4 dunks the other night against a very athletic Washington team.
I feel like I'm working with Donald Trump here with that location, but the ability of Stanford, obviously, to get up and down, freewheeling, terrific in the open floor, and dynamite getting into the lane.
Let's take a look at the starting lineups first for this Minnesota ball club coming in at 23-14. Hollins, Coleman, and Hollins, Andre and Austin, the two Hollins not related in the backcourt. Williams and Eliason up front. For Stanford with a 25-11 record coming into the championship game. Brown, Randall, and Mann in the backcourt up front. Two seniors, Zimmerman and Owens. Owens coming off a sensational game in the semifinal. Johnny Dawkins in his fourth season. He has produced 20-win years with the Stanford Cardinal, one of the great college basketball teams in the history of the ACC. And Tubby Smith approaching 500 wins in his tremendous career. He has 103 at Minnesota.
And now, let's play ball.
Opening tip controlled by Stanford. Two players almost leave the court altogether. Anthony Brown starts it off with a three. He's a 34% long-range shooter.
That's a pretty good sign, huh? Were they 11-1 when he hits doubles?
Yep. It's the fourth game for Stanford in the Garden. They ought to be feeling at home right now.
Got to have their shooting on, shouldn't they?
We are in the right spot. The radio guys will take it out on that nice little dribble drive that time by Coleman.
Good job by Coleman to get the feed, and Williams has been a key for this Minnesota ball club. Mann, who has been starting at the guard spot since Welch was injured.
Tubby saying today that The backcourt play has really made them a tougher team. Good decisions by Hollins, finding people.
What you love about it, Phil, it's a young backcourt.
Mm-hmm.
These guys can be together for 3 years.
They have a toughness, too. Nice penetration, no finish.
Coleman with a scoop, it wouldn't go, and the easy rebound to the 6'8 Zimmerman.
And a nice push against this set D.
Randall from a long way out, nearly tipped in.
Hey, how good has Dre Hollins been, Mike?
Oh, he's been
NIT,
brilliant.
Huh?
Averaging 17 points, 5 rebounds, 3.5 assists a game.
Nice matchup, too, with Randall.
Very much so.
I expect him to have a nice game. A little deflection here. By the way, just in case they're both playing Miniman.
You know, yeah.
Jim Belton's going to be the heat in the truck.
Coleman, another freshman, to inbound.
Nice curl.
Hollins with a runner.
Yes.
Got the bounce. Austin Hollins out of Germantown, Tennessee, averages 9.5 points a game.
Well, you know that double's coming. You got to do a better job on defense, don't you think?
Yeah, that play took a long time to develop. That's a nice jumper.
Owens got off to a quick start the other night, ended up with 15 and 12, his second double-double of the year.
He's been all season long really, really accurate in the lane.
Does a nice job getting there, too, doesn't he? Presented himself with that patented little delivery of his.
A good catch by Williams. Just a save.
You can't overthrow it if you're throwing the run away.
That's for sure.
There's your line again, Fran. The NBA line.
Randall can't get it. The tip won't go for Zimmerman.
Little heel click there.
Andre Hollins really came on at the end of the year. He's hampered by an ankle injury most of the season. Cost him 10 games, and then he wasn't 100% when he came back.
Well, he understands what they want done now and better for it.
Take a look at this now. This play took a while to develop, but really nice job. Eliasson at the top. Good curl screen there by Hollins. And a friendly roll here at the Garden.
Always had attractive rings,
yes.
Didn't they?
Yep.
Pretty good.
Hollins, nice bounce pass, and Coleman with the reverse of the game.
Well, Joe Coleman, another one of those young guards. Two freshmen and a sophomore out there.
Owens,
nice cut.
Play on.
An old Globy ball fake.
And now Eliasson picks up the foul.
Frank, keeping active helps passers, don't you think?
Absolutely. Watch this right here, Bill. A little ball screen. Get behind on the baseline.
Not too bad. Pretty good around the rim, like his uncle, huh?
Uncle Ben?
Yeah.
Really?
Mike, you may have done his games at
Monroe. I did.
Oh, yeah.
He was a sensational center.
And his older brother, Dan, played, I think, graduated in 2007. Watching these young teams, Mike, we talked about this the other night. This is like, I wouldn't say a minor bowl, but it's like a bowl game in football because all this experience, 5 extra games and the practices, gotta help you going into next year.
Coaches love the extra experience. Hollins, tough. Oh, jump shot, and he made it.
Wow, you gotta really hug him, huh?
Which way did he drive? He went
well,
right
you,
again.
You like
come on out.
The other night. Nice back cut here.
Well, that looked like a walk, no call.
Fran scouted for some left.
Williams, tough baseline jumper. Doesn't matter how tough they are, they're all going in.
One from the West Coast, one from the Midwest, huh? Right at home in Manhattan.
You know what you love about Rodney Williams? He's averaging about 21 points a game in the NIT.
He has been absolutely sensational.
Good defense there, prepared for that lob.
He's now leading them in scoring, rebounding, steals, and blocks.
You like him in the low post, don't you?
Yeah, I do. He's really efficient. I watched him early in the year against Syracuse and Oklahoma State. Had a good, solid year for the club.
The lead is 2. He played almost 5 minutes in the first half of this championship game.
So good use
Williams
of the floor.
Williams for 3.
Well, he is... fire. Hunter Tubby with a little fist pump on the sideline.
Rodney Williams, a 29% three-point shooter. He says, so what, and knocks it down.
This is a guy I think has to get going, don't you, Fran?
Yeah, it's early. You know, he's kind of picking his spot for the pressure.
There you go. He picked nice one there.
Right on cue. Right on cue.
He's listening.
Yeah.
I like players that listen, particularly good ones.
That's why they're good ones.
Mm.
13 to 10, Minnesota.
Yeah, when you think of it, the advantage might be from Stanford for the one-day turnaround. They're so used to it all year.
Coleman couldn't get it up from in front of the rim. Man back the other way. Hangs in the leg. Nice.
Hey, how about the execution so far?
Excellent.
Maybe the D a little wanting, but the passing, some pinpoint looks.
Absolutely. And if they're pushing the ball up the floor, you get a great opportunity, Stanford. I think you've got to make them play a little half court. The physicality lacking with Minnesota.
When the help comes, the guards have been able to make the excellent pass. Williams tried again, not this time. Thought he was fouled.
Small change underneath by Hollins.
Off to an exciting offensive start with Stanford and Minnesota. We're at the Garden in New York for the NIT Championship. Great places to play basketball, legendary places. This is the Cage on West 4th Street in Manhattan.
I spent some time here. Take Big Bob Matera and Rock Eisenberg from Brooklyn up to West. We go play, come to Brooklyn and try to get on the court.
You got any blood on those pipes there?
Good basketball experience.
I was around when they called them cages for cager in the old days, but I read a book, right? Martin Dale Jr. wrote a book on the 4th Street playground. And how about nobody in there, incidentally?
No,
which is shocking.
It's amazing.
It was always packed.
Always packed. That's my son's. When we would visit New York, we had to go see West 4th Street Park.
Mm-hmm.
It's like seeing the Empire State Building to them.
Those kids are probably in school. Just don't get it.
Dwight Powell has checked into Stanford's lineup. He wears number 33. This is Owens. Cut off at the baseline. Good defense. He throws it away.
Smart, though. You want him to take it out. You get your defense set.
Well, nice job by Ingram coming in. And
every time we see Andre Ingram, he does the right things.
You know, if it weren't for injuries, he wouldn't be getting all that much playing time.
Exactly.
He will have a nice career. Don't you think? A lot of experience now and a nice, strong body.
Dre Hollins fouled on the way up by Aaron Bright.
There's Trevor Mbakwe.
You had a chance to talk with him, huh?
Yeah, yeah. Really, really quality young man. Off to a great start this year. You see the numbers, and he was hurt against the Dayton Flyers down in the Old Spice Classic. He got his sixth year, Mike, of eligibility.
That's terrific.
And I got the feeling he's going to come back and not test the waters. He's still not at 100%.
That's going to make them a team to watch next year.
Without a question. You're right. Mo Walker is also injured, young big guy. And all these young guards that have just grown up before our eyes the last couple of days.
And a pretty good recruiting class coming in.
Yep.
Just size, I think, is what they need, don't you?
Exactly. Yep. Powell has to kick it out.
And again, what a play, what a read by the little guy.
Andre Hollins has done everything right so far in this game. He's done everything right in the tournament.
Empty side, nice up.
Until now. Right back the other way for the Cardinal.
That's a range. Just testing the waters.
He is a 43.5% long range shooter. Made the All-Pac-12 freshman team this year, and he can fill it up.
And you look at the type of postseason Aaron Wright has had, 29 against Illinois State, 6 assists, Jason Randall.
Mm-hmm.
Two teams that have really grown over these 5 games in the NIT.
It's a great reward, no question about it, for next year. You know, I think of Timmy Tartaway with Dre Hollins. The body?
Yeah.
Think about it.
Mm-hmm.
The stocky, sturdy.
Williams hands it off to Holland. Welch, he can get open. He's got a great stroke from outside as well. Ingram wants the ball low and can't get it to him. Holland's had to pick it up. Powell, nice defense on the double team.
Well, they're reading well, helping out, jamming the lane.
Brown.
Boy, just gave it back. Good, easy look outside.
Good offensive rebound by Hughes, but then he threw it away.
Right at the feet set for just a little shovel pass.
Welch.
Nice help
in the lane. Again, a good double team, and Williams is stripped. Stanford playing some solid defense right now, but throwing it away on the offensive end. Could a scoring lull here. Stanford by one with 11:49 to go in the half.
ESPN's exclusive presentation of the NIT is brought to you by Mercedes-Benz. Experience truly great engineering today at your authorized dealer. And ING.
Welcome back to New York City. Stanford by one over Minnesota in the championship game of the NIT. And for the Golden Gophers, the future looks very bright right now as they are picking it up at the end of this season. Next year, well, you know Tubby Smith's going to get it done. Always has, no everywhere question. He's been.
Yep, they'll have them. Trevor and Bachway back. They've signed a couple guys. They'll have Big Mo Williams back. And, you know, I mentioned earlier, guys, you heard me say this the other night about Dre Hollins. He's dominant to his right hand right now, and I hope he's listening. I hope someone in his family's listening, and because eventually teams are going to figure out that you want to force him to the left hand, and that's what you work on in the offseason.
Well, I've had guys that hear people like you say that, and they keep going right just to prove you wrong.
Yeah, I understand. Yeah.
Expanding their game.
Yeah.
Armland is in for the first time. Chip wears number 23 for the Gophers.
Well, I think everybody does what we do. Really wants to help the kids get
absolutely
better.
You know,
and help the coach help the kid, kind of. Look, even that guy, he couldn't win, but he knows what he's talking about.
Yeah.
Meaning me, not you.
Welch with a pull-up. Doesn't get the bounce. And the rebound goes to Hustis.
They have a nice rotation. 9-10 guys.
Stanford has added three more quality recruits as well to this young mix.
Wright having a tough time with Owens.
Well, they really hang tough with their pivot foot, don't they? Lock it in, Mike.
Powell's a kid with a lot of athleticism. He's 6'7", 200 pounds. Not that big a guy physically, but he's got some interior skills.
And I think he plays terrific defense because a lot of it's been the help defense.
Followed by Ingram. Again, nothing spectacular from Ingram. Just all the plays you want to see a guy make.
Look at that help. Nice double. Goes right on top of it.
Still, both teams doing a good job of that double team.
Yeah, they sure are. Nice understanding of where to be. Once again, Powell, Nagini. How about him on that defensive end?
We're just laying in wait that time. Wright calls out the play he wants as we approach the 10-minute mark. Randall, guarded by Welch, gets it to Brown. Hit his first shot, can't hit that one.
Nice tip.
Ooh, Gary, huh?
How about the little
little greedy
card, yeah.
Williams!
Holy
cow. Rodney Williams, who had done everything this year but make threes, is now making those. He has 10 first half points.
I think they're gonna get to know where he is. Nice little fade.
Right. Williams with another rebound.
Well, we always knew Rodney Williams had that ridiculous athletic ability.
Timeout. They got a good have
it. Good call.
Give it to, yeah, that's the right call.
Yep. Oh. Team have possession.
Good call by Carl Hess. Good officiating crew with Carl Hess, Jim Burr, and Mike Roberts. working tonight. The NCAA Division I Women's Championship continues with the Final Four Sunday night on ESPN. It all starts with the NCAA Women's Final Four special at 6, then at 6:30 Eastern, UConn-Notre Dame. Finally, at 8:30 Eastern, Stanford goes against Baylor. The question is, can anybody even slow down Brittany Griner?
A shot ball arrived there, huh?
Yeah, I guess the committee did a good job, yeah, right?
Absolutely.
Nice cut.
Everybody. Beautiful.
Bezatostis.
Williams says, I can do this too.
You tell me Rodney Williams is not going to come out of this tournament with even more confidence than he had coming in.
7-0 run. Bright trying to end that. Had to pick up his dribble. Goes to Randle. Boy, and they've gone cold. A lot of it due to the Minnesota defense.
Yeah, they've stopped any penetration.
Williams, well, you got to go out in his face now, don't you?
Looks like an easy game to referee, by the way.
Yeah. Armland, good hesitation, then lost his balance and charges.
An easy call, too.
Tubby not happy over there.
Years ago, I had a chance to do some of Tubby's games, and he always talked about Frank McGuire and his influence when he was at South Carolina. He said every day he would go in and sit down with Frank.
How about that staff? George Felton was the head coach. Tubby, Joe Dooley, now at Kansas, right? Joe was on that staff.
Kansas losing a few coaches, right?
Hey, Danny Manning, what a great job he did at Kansas.
All the big guys
have improved.
Here's the offensive foul. Little frustration owns.
Josh Owens picks up his first.
You told us about Ingram in that Miami game.
Oh, he was sensational.
And he's been pretty good for two nights.
Garbage.
You can go through an entire game and not, if you're a fan, not really notice him all that much. You look at the stat sheet afterward and he's done everything to tip the balance in their favor.
9 points, 5 rebounds the other night.
And tough.
Great body too.
Williams knocked away. Good job by Powell.
He can guard this kid.
Welch, nice step back to get the shot, but he can't hit it. Offensive rebound to Armland and a fresh 35.
He nice went left.
Yay. Yeah.
Now you're going to take credit for that? He also lost the ball going
out. That's my point. He'll work on that. He'll hear me. He'll say, I'll tell that Fran Fischella. Wait till he sees me next year.
Maybe they were just taking it away from him, you know?
Man, short on a jumper. Minnesota trying to run. Hollins. Offensive foul.
Which way to go, Bill?
Yeah, unfortunately, he got a charge.
We may have to review this going left thing.
We're helping you. Work on that left hand this summer, Dre. You're going to be pretty good.
You're helping Stanford.
Minnesota with a 4-point lead. One of the reasons is Rodney Williams.
This guy's had another really good season at Minnesota. And, of course, one of the best athletes in the country. We got the dunk contest tonight, right?
Unbelievable. How about him facing up now? That's what I think. What a turnaround, Fran. Yeah. A little nylon on a pull-up. Catch, shoot, drive. That's showing Tuffy's got a little flair for this game.
He's hit 2 out of 3 3-point shots tonight. Coming in, he was 15 of 51. That's only 29.4%. Against Washington, 18 points. He already has 10 in this game, and we've got 7-12 to go in the first half. Stanford contributing to its own problems. The Cardinal has not scored in 3:30.
Rodney, 56%, and of course, it's aided by those little chips around the rim, don't you think?
Absolutely. Well, I'll tell you why, he'll be in the gym all spring and summer shooting threes, won't he?
Absolutely. Get the little dribble game going as well, because he does have that pull-up. After a timeout, you usually go inside.
Zimmerman just tossed it up there, and they got very lucky as Eustace was there with a follow.
They were trying to go to Owens, but once again, Minnesota's defense has been solid.
Hollins against Bright, and Bright will be called for getting him on the arm. That's one on the sophomore from Bellevue, Washington.
Did you teach touch and release like on a drive, like he just couldn't get away from the guy. It's hard once they turn on you.
Yeah, I just wanted them to move their feet and stay in front. You know, depends on how officials call it.
Mm-hmm. Are you suggesting Jim Burris calling it close?
No. I think particularly the East, they let you get a little more physical.
Right. Guys.
Welch, nice drive to get open. Bounce pass to Coleman, a little floater won't go. And here comes Mann for Stanford. Got by Hollins, missed it. The follow won't go either. Josh Owens tried to flush it and missed it. Block inside by Stanford and a steal by Mann. Good get back. And Mann scores. Nice pass by Bright.
Challenged. They're letting them go a little bit now, Fred.
Yeah.
Welch, that's a reach around and a foul on Owens.
This is pretty basketball, although nice Euro step crossover.
Got to use a little more spin on that layup.
It's funny, when you go too hard, you don't have that soft release at the glass, do you? Boy, there's some athletes out here right now.
This is sort of a, you know, we talked about Stanford increasing that tempo in the postseason. This is sort of a Minnesota type of game, even though they've gotten out a couple times in transition.
But one's more physical and one might be deeper.
Right.
Which wins out? I guess we'll wait and see, huh?
That's why you and I are here.
Right, exactly.
Williams. Offensive foul. Good job by Zimmerman. The only question was he outside of that arc?
I stood under the basket when I came in today like a sightseer in New York, and it's too close to college.
Yeah.
I mean, I stood directly under, and you can just see it's...
I might see him go to the pro line, wouldn't you?
I think it's much easier for the officials.
I talked to Mike Roberts, one of the officials, before the game, and he told me officials are getting used to the restricted arc. They're not totally comfortable with it yet after year one.
Aaron Bright got it, and the foul!
Once again, an imperfect closeout. These two guards have range, don't they?
They really do, and this guy's having a great pro season. Young man who knocked in 29 against Illinois State, averaging about 17-18 overall in the postseason. And the sophomore, you get a chance to play some basketball, come to New York, do it on the world's most famous arena stage.
Dre Hollins, the foul. He got a little bump that drove him in, and number two on him. That really will hurt their cause in the backcourt.
8-0 run for Stanford after they suffered a scoring drought for 3.5 minutes. And Aaron Bright is shooting almost 70% from three-point range in the NIT. 70. Maverick on Ahanmisa is into the ball game.
Nice give.
Williams partially blocked by Hustis. Good defense. Right back the other way.
He loves that little ball fake, doesn't he?
Nice pass to Hustis.
And that's what you, the benefit of running the floor, that's what you get, a nice easy one in the lane. Even numbers, you might say Aaron is a bright light early here for Stanford.
Well, you might say that. Stanford up by 6 against Minnesota, 4:51 to go in the half.
Previously on my son's TV show.
Why don't you show him how it's done?
How do you propose to your wife?
You see that?
We won late.
I know a lot of Justin Bieber songs.
Flap a flap.
Did he bring anything to eat?
But he's beautiful.
Ever have a teammate that you were a little bit afraid of? Roaring with delight and rage. You don't have to put him up to that.
Not a shining moment. It's your fault.
Do you ever think about bringing the Jerry Curls back? See? Oh, no.
No!
The Dan Le Batard Show. Weekdays on ESPN America.
.451 to go in the first half. The Cardinal zooms out to a 6-point lead, 27-21. Talk about a look ahead. They look pretty good.
Oh, no question. That Roscoe Allen played with Shabazz Muhammad at Bishop Gorman. I think that young man was the MVP last night, right? McDonald's game, Shabazz Muhammad.
Big numbers, most of them in the first half.
Yep.
Williams tried a floater, couldn't hit it. Huestis with another rebound. Minnesota has gone cold. Bright.
That's what made this game. He dances for that three or the pull-up. They got a quick, they're going to check if it's a two or a three.
I keep thinking back to the NBA Finals last year when J.J. Barea tortured the Miami Heat. And he's got that little J.J. hot fire hydrant game.
Well, he was starting earlier in the year. Now he comes off the bench and is averaging, as you can see, he's inside that line. He's averaging over 17 points a game off the bench. And some coaches really like to bring a guy like that off the bench because they know what they're going to get.
No, absolutely. And he's, for all intents and purposes, a sixth starter.
They call him a fake sub. Or, you know what I mean?
How easy is that to sell to a kid?
Well, it depends on how much he wants to win or he feels he can contribute. And, Dion Wade is Boeheim. He's not the most pleasant of gentlemen in terms of direction. You're a sub. But the Waiters being maybe one of the best six men in the country. And, this young guy sort of has bought in.
Josh Huestis picks up his first foul. He's going to send Austin Hollins to the line. Son of the former Trailblazer Lionel Hollins.
Who played a few games in this building, yeah, I'm sure he did. I'm sure Lionel Hollins didn't worry about which line was which, right?
He didn't. He was a terrific player. Got that ring in Portland.
And Arizona State, maybe? And then
I think so, yeah.
And he played with Bobby Gross. Some guy named Walton wasn't bad, right?
That's right.
Mo Lucas.
Chris Bill, when healthy, was something special.
Oh, man.
Sure was.
Got to think Bill Walton, when healthy, one of three, four best centers of all time.
Absolutely.
Russell, Singer, Jabbar.
Tells you how the league has changed, too.
Yeah.
A lot of forwards or guys who face up at that five spot.
A little pressure here from Minnesota.
A little two-three zone by the Tubmaster.
First points in almost 4.5 minutes, and Bright with a runner.
Indeed.
You need that little floater in your game when you're diminutive.
But I know about diminutive. Like a wash tub to him right now.
Spoken with authority.
Well, look at the man.
Nice help. Well, they are doing a heck of a job being out of bounds. He's hollering. Jim Bird doesn't want to hear anything from an assistant coach. He didn't want to hear anything from a head coach. A kinder, gentler Jim Burr. Only two hands.
Well, he sure heard that one, and Bright is making a lot of noise himself.
Burns Studio coming up at the half. 2 days to the Final Four. Miles Simon in studio offers his Final Four keys for Kentucky Louisville and Ohio State Kansas, plus a mass exodus from Chapel Hill to the NBA. We'll explain who's going, who's staying at the half. Mike, Fran, and Raph, we'll see you in a few.
Hey, Ryan, the whole team left. I mean, everybody. The 2012 NCAA Men's Final Four begins Saturday at 6 o'clock on CBS. Louisville against Kentucky, a chance to go to the national championship. For more information, go to NCAA.com.
Tough day for Roy Williams, huh?
Oh, goodness.
Well, good luck to all those guys.
He will get a few more.
I think so. I think Roy's got some ammunition coming in.
Yeah, I think he knows. They've been down that road before.
Yeah, recruiting class has never been a problem for Roy Williams. Stanford on a 14-2 run here, and they're up by 8. Bright has 8 of those points.
Out of that 2-3, didn't take too many trips in it.
I get the feeling that Minnesota might miss Clay Hollins. There's two fouls.
It is a good move. A little slippage.
Austin Hollins trying to clamp down on Bright. Shot clock at 6. And that's an offensive foul. Zimmerman picks up the personal.
Well, take a look at this. I don't want to throw Gray Hollins under the bus, but watch how effective he is going to his right. And then coming back to that left hand, we talked about it, a turnover. Another drive left, a little out of control. And I say that again, and I really mean this. This young man, Mike, has had a phenomenal end of season. But you got to take what you need to work on in the spring and summer and come back even better next year. So this is going to be a really good basketball team. he's going to be an outstanding point guard.
When you're playing with him off the floor, I mean, he's a different basketball team right now.
No question.
Ahan Misi at the top of the circle. Ingram.
That's a good pass to Williams.
And that is a charge.
Boy, let's see that one. That was a little deep, and I thought a little motion. They do cut well, though. Unfortunately, leading you to the well. Nice dive. There's the NBA line. What do you think?
I think he got there. I think he got there. Of course, he's, you know, again, I make that point. They're so worried about making sure the player defender's feet are outside the restricted arc that sometimes I'm not sure they're watching whether the defender was set. But well, that was good.
Yeah,
that was bang,
right.
Bang.
It was a good call.
Bang, bang.
Yeah, honestly, with the bang bangers, you can go either way. Somebody's not happy. No question about it.
Boy, Randall has gotten away with that little move a couple of times. Bright stripped on the way in. Welch. Well, they really had an advantage in numbers, and Welch didn't use it.
Got to get up on play. They do. Let's him go to the hole a little bit. A little out of control.
Both teams a little sloppy here when they try to get out and go. Welch with the long jump shot, and the rebound goes to Powell.
Johnny wants to pull it out, run something.
1:43 to go in the first half. The lead is 8 for the Cardinal.
How awful when you go up and down like they've been trying to do. It gets a little out of sorts.
Johnny put that stop sign up.
A great temperament, doesn't he?
Another strip as Brown couldn't get his shot off. Williams, collision, and that's going to be a block. Didn't quite get there.
Right, right, just a step slow. But Williams pretty good in the open floor, too. Good foot speed.
Here he comes. He's coming right at you. Let's see. Aaron Bright trying to back up. He's never really set, so got to be legally guarding 2 feet on the ground, and I don't think he really ever sees still moving. And yep. See, once he's got both feet, he can slide and move backwards. Or, what did I say the other night? Obliquely.
I heard.
I went back and checked.
Is there a Q in obliquely?
I'm not sure.
There's two of them.
I didn't say I could spell it.
Yeah, Rodney, that time may have had a turnover. You know, if he didn't get the call, you
know,
understand?
I know. Absolutely.
Got to pull it up and be under control.
21 points, 5.5 rebounds. His average in the NIT. He has just been sensational.
And we made some draft blog lists as a freshman, and I thought his skill level at that time was very low. But he's a junior now. And, you know, he was thinking about putting his name in as a freshman. But you can see this is why when guys like this guy stay 3 or 4 years, how much they can develop and improve.
You wish more would, you know, although a lot of guys free, let me some learn guys, while some, I get paid.
Yeah, some guys figure it out and have the opportunity. I think Kendall Marshall, I think it's a good time for him to go, Bill, because he's got nobody to pass to next year except young guys.
He just had to throw up at the glass, didn't he? The top of the glass.
Good block by Eliason. Has seen very few minutes here in the first half.
Ooh,
and that's a palm call on Coleman. I wish they'd make that call more often.
The Allen Iverson. Remember he stopped up that
they,
baby?
They do in November and December. Then they get into conference play. But that's the correct call by Mike Roberts. We've got three of the best out here tonight.
You know, Fran, I have a question for you. Why don't more college coaches use the clock to their advantage?
Two for ones.
And I mean, a lot of guys just pass on it.
It's funny you say that, because in my region, watching Kansas this week, Tyshawn Taylor in the first half of both games took shots that you would say, well, that's a quick one.
But he did it for the two
you,
for one.
You look up at the clock, and Bill Self is one of those guys that'll use the two for one.
And a lot of guys would make sure it's a good one.
Yeah.
Or they don't, otherwise, don't take it.
Yeah.
The heck with the 2-for-1.
Well, we talked about everything that Rodney Williams has done. And he's a good teammate as well.
Everybody gets
all
a
way down to
everybody
the end
got
of the
it. Everybody
even
got
Roger, it. Even Roger Shipper, the trainer, got one.
Yeah.
Well, he might get a dollar of the meal money from each guy for that, too.
the gopher, you see the gopher got him.
Did he get a
piece? He got a little piece.
Piece
there.
Of the action?
Yeah.
He slapped hands with a guy who had a ticket. Here's your answer, the old pro. Trying to get a two for one, but you got to take advantage of that too. Welch back the other way.
Nice help. But they do a nice job collapsing defensively.
And Bill, speaking of good teammates, I was talking to Trevor and Bakwe before the game, and we talked about how he was so excited the other night. Mm-hmm. Remember when he was hugging
sure.
jumping up and down? I said it looked like you won that $500 million lottery.
I'm sure you bet your tickets a nice trip again. We have seen great hands on both ends. You don't need any money anymore. I mean, the lottery would be you any good. You have to give it away just to cover your taxes.
You know, the line out the door, the bodega there up on 57th and 9th. Couldn't even get in.
Is that right?
No, I just made that up.
Oh, okay. And they were just trying to get the post.
Welch trying to get loose for an open outside shot.
Nice pass.
Hey! Lost it on the way up.
Jump ball. And go the other way.
Eliasson and Powell were tied up. Boy, and Powell's really upset.
Eliasson, too. He went right after him.
Good effort.
Yeah.
I like it. Eliasson threw a great pass. Ingram came up empty. And Eliasson just reached in, grabbed the ball. We saw him make a couple heady plays the other night.
He's a good passer.
Yeah.
He's really a good passer. Nice yep. look. And he's excited on that pass.
He thinks he's got an assist.
Yeah, Ingram just, and they keep going and scuffling. And this is a nice little job by the referees. Just good competitive effort to get it.
Full court pressure. Shot clock is off. Randall. Six to shoot, and he walked.
Nice defense there collectively.
We have seen defensive spurts mm-hmm. by both teams where they have really looked terrific.
Yeah, not, he's not happy with the turnovers, I'm sure.
That forced Randall left the second half.
Ahanmisi at the buzzer.
Well, if these respective teams get to know their left from their right, they're going to walk out of here with a win the NIT.
We're at the half at the NIT. Let's go to Ryan Burr and Miles Simon in the studio for the halftime report.
All right, Mike, the Cardinal up by six at the break. Championship game of the NIT, 31-25 at the break. Ryan Burr along with former Arizona great Miles Simon. And Miles, as we do every year now, as we get closer to the Final Four, the teams that don't make it there, their stars usually end up taking the next step, and that's exactly what's happened at North Carolina, the preseason number one team. A lot of guys came back, decided to make a run at the title. Didn't happen, and today underclassmen Harrison Barnes, John Henson, and Kendall Marshall all threw their name in for the NBA draft, saying it's a great day for three youngsters who are taking another step towards their ultimate goal of playing professional basketball, that from head coach Roy Williams in a statement. So obviously three great players didn't quite reach their goal of winning a national title. Your thoughts of jumping to the pros?
I think they're all making the right decision. They're all going to be first round draft picks, if not lottery picks. Barnes is the guy that people probably feel the most disappointed about. He was the National High School Player of the Year, the number one recruit in the country. They didn't get to the Final Four or win a national championship with this great group of players that are all going to the NBA this year, but I think they're all making the right move for their own benefit, and definitely Roy Williams is going to support that, and these guys are going to be first round picks, and they're all tremendous players.
Well, so much talk of not having the one and done and making sure these guys stay. All three of those guys stayed in college for at least 2 years, so at least for the Tar Heel faithful, they got to, you know, at least experience their talents for more than 1 year, which is more than we could say about a lot of guys anymore.
Yeah, they did, and it was great that they came back, and they had a goal of trying to win the national title this year, and they were on track to do that. I had them winning the title. Kendall Marshall suffers the unfortunate wrist injury, which completely changed the fate of Tar Heel basketball season.
All right, let's move to some big coaching news. Illinois has been out there lingering. Couple offers and no's were the answer, but today they finally got their guy. It is John Gross, who took Ohio further than any coach had taken them in 50 years. He was introduced as the Illini's new head coach. He's saying, obviously, our family is excited to be part of a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity. Danny Manning has agreed to become the head coach at Tulsa, the second assistant from Kansas coach Bill Self's staff to announce his departure prior to the Final Four. Manning will help lead the Jayhawks in New Orleans before taking over at Tulsa, where, oh, by the way, Bill Self once served as the team's head coach. Speaking of the Jayhawks in New Orleans, when we come back, we take a look at the Final Four. Miles offers his keys to both semifinal games. Stay with us.
When we get it right, we're number one seeds and we're playing in Final Fours.
For college basketball players and for coaches, it's the Final Four. It's what we all dream about.
Number one Kentucky is in the Final Four.
The Louisville Cardinals are going to the Final Four.
The Ohio State way is now in effect.
His team's going to play well. My team's going to play well. One of us will win. One of us will lose. March on. Go home. Each game is like it's your last. Let's go play it out.
The 2012 Final Four kicks off Saturday with a couple of rematches. Kentucky defeated Louisville earlier this season. Kansas toppled Ohio State without Jared Sullinger earlier this year. The four schools, boy, have they combined for a whole lot of success. 49 Final Fours, 13 national titles. Our Andy Katz talked with Kentucky star Anthony Davis about his health heading into Saturday night.
I felt great. I'm not going to lie. I heard it. It felt sore, tight. I really couldn't move it. I guess it's just all the adrenaline, during the game. So it started hurting. But after that, just get treatment, ice, rest, relax, and then had an off day, so I kind of got a lot of treatment that day. I didn't do a lot of full contact Tuesday, but Wednesday I did the whole practice. Tuesday practice I did a lot of riding the bike, did a lot of running when we did a lot of running. But contact I really didn't do much.
Well, obviously, Anthony Davis being healthy is key, considering he's the likely player of the year. Miles, let's take a look at all four teams now in the semifinals and start with Kentucky, the favorite to win it all. They win Saturday if.
I think Kentucky wins Saturday if. They just play like themselves. Don't put too much pressure on yourself. Play like you're the best. For them, it's not about X's and O's. You're the most talented team out there. Just show it. Don't do things that you don't normally do like they did in the SEC championship where they shot 28 threes against Vandy. Can't let the underdog hang around and gain a lot of confidence. Just play like you're the best, like you're the champion and supposed to win. And for Louisville, they win if they're active in their zone, try to make Kentucky a three-point shooting team. They got to score points and keep their turnovers low. Keeping Kentucky is out of transition is the biggest key in that. Kentucky gets 22 points a game in the NCAA tournament from transition, and rebounding with Bohannon and Couric digging back in that zone is very important. They gave up 20 offensive rebounds in the first matchup.
Kentucky nearly a double-digit favorite to beat Louisville on Saturday night. The next game, the nightcap, predicted to be a little bit closer as we get a rematch of Ohio State and Kansas. Of course, the Jayhawks beat the Buckeyes the first time around. No Jared Sullinger for the Buckeyes. They advance if.
If Deshaun Thomas has a big game. Deshaun Thomas starts at the four spot, but he's a matchup problem for most teams because he goes inside and out. He's been great in the NCAA tournament, averaging 21-8, shooting 41% from the three. Thomas Robinson's going to start on him, but you don't want to see Thomas Robinson chasing Deshaun Thomas on the perimeter too much, but he's the matchup problem. But for KU, they win if Tyshawn Taylor can take care of the basketball. Had six turnovers while Aaron Kraft was guarding him in the first matchup, even though he was playing with a torn meniscus. He's 0-for-17 from the three-point line in the NCAA tournament, but when he scored well in the regional final with 22 points is when Kansas was clicking on all cylinders and routed the Tar Heels.
And of course, you get all your Final Four reports from our game day guys live on SportsCenter all weekend long as we prepare for the finals. The women's tournament, you can watch it right here on ESPN as the Final Four, all number one seed, 6:30 and 8:30 Sunday night. What a Final Four it will be from Denver. More after this. What a year it was for Marcus Denman. He is warming up for the State Farm College Slam Dunk 3-Point Championships from New Orleans. Loosening up that right arm. It's all coming up after the NIT championship game. Stanford leads by 6 at the break. Second half from the Garden. It's next. Enjoy it.
This game is streaming live on your computer, tablet, or smartphone via WatchESPN.com and the WatchESPN app.
Another of the legendary playgrounds in New York, Goat Park, named after Earl the Goat, a legendary player in this city.
That is East Harlem, Bill, 98th Street area.
Did you play against?
I didn't. No.
Did you post them up?
I thought it was a little before my time.
It is a six-point lead in this ball game, and really, this was a tale of two halves because Minnesota came out like they were going to just blow them out of this building, and you got to hand it to Stanford. They came back very strongly.
Absolutely. Ronnie Williams had a great NIT. He's almost doubled his scoring average, averaging about 21. And early on, we know he can dunk the ball, but he showed you a little bit of versatility, gives you a little bit of everything. What a confidence builder. But you know what, Bill? Stanford came back.
They sure did, and the reason was a bright spot. Eric, everybody on the breakout. Good handle. You got to get him on the catch. You can drill a four-point play there. But finding people with three assists, and I love the old ball fake, huh? The Globies aren't in town, but Aaron sure is.
Minnesota went the last 8 minutes and 49 seconds of the half without a field goal. Hit a couple of free throws, but it was the Bright and Williams show.
He gets a seat for all that work, though.
He'll start the second half just the way he started the game. They have used him as a sixth man, and he has been unbelievable in that role.
See if Minnesota can run their half-court stuff.
Andre Hollins spent a lot of the first half on the bench as well. That was a factor.
Randall almost face-guarding him. Take him out of the run, take the head out.
Pretty good matchup of a couple of freshmen who are going to be superstars.
Now that's a great point, and they both played really well at the end of the season for their respective clubs.
Well, Johnny saying, I guess Illinois was one of the ones that was in the hunt. Nice back screen, but great pressure by Zimmerman. Look at this.
Loose ball, and man will get the jam. Outstanding defense by Stanford.
The two seniors, Zimmerman and Mann, they don't play a ton of minutes. But Johnny Dawkins starts them for that reason. They bring you some intensity.
Hollins almost lost it again.
Once again, good pressure on the sideline by Randall. You know, good hands, huh?
You know, we were imagining that Lorenzo Romar halftime speech, and I wonder what Tubby said to these guys.
Nice slip, but tough catch
right through the hand of Eliason. Minnesota can ill afford to continue to turn it over at this pace. Man, again. Nice fake by Mann, and it gave him an uncontested layup, and now the biggest lead of the ball game for the Stanford Cardinal at 35-25.
I'll tell you, Stanford is guarding. They got a hold here on the hip hug by Brown, I believe.
Field goal percentage heavily in favor of Stanford. They've hit 3 out of 7 from long range, and the bench points courtesy of Bright, a 14-4 advantage there.
Ingram back in, maybe give some solid play around the rim.
Pretty good defense, huh?
I like it.
Yeah,
that was good help right there.
Nice move by Hollins. Good bounce pass. Coleman inside, and Coleman charges.
They got a trip. I think they're, interesting. Mike Roberts had the foul before the lost ball.
That's good teamwork right there.
Yeah, it is. It is.
Jim Burr was on the other side of the basket. Mike Roberts was in that center position. And
yeah, there's the foul, no question. Anytime it goes to a turnover like that, pretty good shot. Coleman took on the hip.
Inbound to Williams.
You know, we should tell our players, just put your foot on the side, on the baseline. Mm-hmm.
Remember when guys started forcing force out. Baseline? Yeah.
Force out.
Yeah. Hollins to Coleman. Stanford just can't get an open look. Or Minnesota. Ingram jump hook and he missed.
Hey, they have really turned the faucet off here.
Brown got it.
Nice screen to set him up, and nobody showed. Johnny wants to pressure a little bit. He wants to get this thing going.
Anthony Brown, another youngster, makes it a 12-point advantage.
Well, he's only a sophomore.
Nice defense by Zimmerman. A hole. Good call. Number three.
Zimmerman has made a couple of decent plays defensively in the open court. 6'8", 230.
He starts because he and Mann, the two seniors, they kind of set the tone, and then the young guys come in, but they've been good defensively.
Sensational. It really shut off everything. Maybe too much dribbling on the perimeter.
Yeah, I think
for
so.
Minnesota, maybe pass the ball.
Well, they're going left, too.
Yeah. They've read your scouting report.
Big foul call as well because it's on Andre Hollins, his third. Mann looking for another field goal. Instead, they go to the baseline with Zimmerman. Powell may have gotten away with a little push to get the offensive rebound. Zimmerman, the left hand, draws a foul.
It'll be Walsh on the other side.
I don't want to say Johnny Dawkins was confused this year, but he never did settle on a lineup. That's pretty good right there. Everybody gets, you know what, practices are good because everybody knows they're going to play.
Yeah, would you agree with this?
Yeah,
I think they have a lot of even players.
They do.
That's the problem. So nobody shows, or they might show a little today, next game.
That's
right. And that's why they're always juggling, trying to strike oil.
And the other reason for it, he likes to match up. He thinks certain of his players have skills that are best against whoever the other team normally has for a starting five.
And he's, you know, it's not like it hasn't worked. He's trying to get his 25th win.
And he went to Duke, so we know he's smart to start with.
He puts his hands on his hips like Pat Riley, doesn't he?
He does. He's got the clothes,
yeah,
and the finances to afford it.
Boy, that was. Ingram tried to feed it down low.
Particularly against the suffocating interior defense. They really helped beautifully.
Brown.
Nice play by Powell again. Slapping it off Welsh. Well, he has had a heck of a game.
And Johnny, we know how good a player he was at Duke. You saw Mike in his heyday. The player, I think, that turned Duke basketball around.
He was the key to Mike Krzyzewski's great start when he was able to turn that program around. And without Johnny Dawkins, it probably wouldn't have happened.
Well, and he had overcome Jay Billis, too. I mean, it's not an easy thing to be a freshman, and that's your load-up guy.
There are more shots for Johnny.
Nice man cut. Back to Zimmerman. Sure, Billis go to the boards, get him the ball, and kick it back out.
Well, he'd get an offensive rebound. It was out of his range. They would have kicked it out.
Shot clock at four.
And that's the only play he could do.
Brown caught in the lane, forced it up, got his own rebound.
Well, they're getting out hustled. And out tough. Something right. You don't say about Tubby's guys.
You are right.
You pointed out the other night that low clock, the only thing you could do is really lob it up.
9-0 run. Brown called for his foul.
You got to watch the ball in your man when you play it out of bounds. Take a look right now. Who is that, Bill? That's Hollins. See, yep. Hollins is watching Brown. He's not paying attention to the inbounder. You can get that like once a game.
You know, there's 4 seconds there. They could run some other things, but you got to figure it might come to you when you're guarding that guy. It's worth bellying him out of the lane.
Stanford has just been suffocating Minnesota. Williams with a miss. Hollins, offensive rebound. Austin Hollins with a big bucket, but it's still 13 points. The first Minnesota field goal in over 12 and a half minutes. And Brown goes, or Randall goes right to the rack.
Tell you what, you need stops. You can't give carte blanche like that.
Outstanding defense by Stanford has given them a 15-point lead.
Nice pass that time, though. Nice cut as well.
Ingram draws the foul. He'll shoot free throws when we come back. 15:38 left.
We get one opportunity in life, one chance in life. To do whatever you're gonna do, to lay your foundation, to make whatever mark you're gonna make, whatever legacy you're gonna leave, leave your legacy. And it's found through effort. Wins and losses come a dime a dozen. But effort, nobody can judge effort.
I don't know about you. I don't know about you, but I'm ready to give some really good analysis right now.
This was set up by one of the Stanford coaches, had Ray Lewis come in and deliver his inspirational speech. What a bonus for these kids. That guy is one of the best I've ever been around.
It's incredible. He's been able to do it. Yeah. He's our age, too, when you think of it, 37. Still able to bang people.
He said once when he was really hurt before a game we were doing, I said, are you going to play? And he says, it's all mind over matter. I don't mind, so it don't matter. And he played. And
that
played well.
Was that, what a memory for these kids, though.
And I think it's carried over. See, that's how good the talk was. It's carried over two nights.
He must have mentioned defense in there somewhere because they're playing it. Minnesota had a 21-17 lead. They have been outscored 25-6 since then.
Now this is Duke type of defense, isn't it? I mean, they are in great position, help side.
And Johnny's such a great figure at this particular school. Stanford fits him like a glove.
Well, that's too easy.
Yeah. Oh, goodness.
Just caught it in rhythm.
For a little double screen, and he slid right into the three-second lane. Goodness.
44-28. They could use some Andre Holland's magic right now. Ingram looking low to Williams. Wasn't open. Nobody's been open.
Well, Eustace took away that lane. The offense with the either guy now.
Good call by Carl Hess. Little chicken wing.
Yeah, Welsh.
I like it. I really like the way they've guarded. Mm-hmm. They're sound. You know, their one-on-one defense is pretty good, and then the help and the containment from everybody else has been outstanding.
They're in the right spot, aren't they? I mean, each trip.
And Tubby's team is guarded well in the NIT.
They're just having trouble on offense now.
I agree.
There's a hole away from the ball.
These are two teams you will likely see, and you hope you see them in the NCAA tournament next year, because you've got a lot of good young players out there on both teams. Guys that are injured will come back.
If I was a fan of either one of these teams, I'd be optimistic.
What do you think the Pac-12 is about scheduling, too? Do they go play?
Well, I think so, Bill, in recruiting, you know.
Oh, no question.
Yeah, they're really suffering recruiting, but some schools in the Pac-12 are really having outstanding years, including the guy Sean Miller at Arizona.
UCLA with UCLA, right?
Yep. Maybe you may have a top five class when it's all said and done.
Powell back again, and he walked.
Nice little wrinkle. Same play with a little duck in.
Friday night, we have an NBA doubleheader for you. It all starts with the Kia NBA countdown at 7:30 Eastern. Then at 8, the Mavericks and the Magic. At 10:30, the Trailblazers and the Clippers. Also available on ESPN3 and live on WatchESPN.com and the WatchESPN app. Hollins. Boy, could they use that one.
Get another chance.
Whoa.
I think Hollins is just trying to make something happen right now.
Not coming easy for him.
It's going to be a hole. That's Williams' third.
Rodney having a dialogue with Jim Bird. It's usually one-sided. It's much like being home.
Yeah.
Yes, no, you have a chance with Jim Burr.
And you don't see
yes,
Powell. Nice athletic move, but he couldn't hit it. Williams with a rebound. I was going to say Minnesota could use an easy basket. They could use any kind of a basket.
It's been tough. He's in the right spot.
Withering defense. Williams is fouled by Brown.
Boy, a lot of whistles lately, huh?
How about this travel? Now they are on the verge, or they got a lot of work to do, but to win this tournament, they would have done it with no home games. And there's the travel. Of course, Tubby's going to be able to take Donna to Hawaii after the season.
He deserves it after going through this and all the injuries all year long. Great family.
Powell and Eliason are picking up where they left off in the first half, and Jim Burr's having. Jim is like the officer on the. Remember in the neighborhood on the street corner, kept everything calm.
If I were a ref, I might say, fellas, we're going to do 2 minutes now. You two go after one another.
We'll see how tough everybody is.
Good job by Powell. Hustles back and knocks it away.
He has been all over defensively,
much quicker than Eliason.
He's a young man from Toronto who was pretty heavily recruited and chose Stanford over some high-level powers. And, of course, that's where Johnny's trying to get the program back to, kind of where Mike Montgomery had it.
Compete at that level.
Absolutely.
Each and every year.
Collins twins.
Welch.
Nice follow.
There you go. Great follow, and that's huge. Austin Collins from the baseline left with the jam.
That stirred up a few people.
We'll see they really got to step it up.
Right, they see if they can counter now, Mike, with a stop.
Powell wants to take Eliason into the lane.
And Eliason didn't have to foul. He had support back there.
Austin Holland just working on the weak side. There's the Karen. That's that Jeff Van Gundy 70% rule. You know, 70% of shots taken from one side will bounce off to the other and
just seal your guy off, right?
Powell up the line, knocks down the first one. He's a 70% shooter.
Although he told me, Bill, that 95% of your shots were missed and bounced to the other side.
They came back at me. These kids played terrific. A lot of kids from Canada all over.
Absolutely.
That would be a factor.
Especially Toronto.
To the world. Yeah.
Yeah. Thanks, Steve Nash, for that. And in fact, Dick Davey, who's retiring tonight, Stanford assistant coach Steve Nash.
Good kick out to Bright, who's back in the ball game. That's a rarity, missing a wide open three.
Because Leo Rattles goes way back to it.
Yeah.
How's that national team?
Yep.
From Andy.
Actually, he started Minnesota and then transferred.
Double foul here. Welch and Bright, and there's your guy, terrific man, so well respected. Sam Shuley, an old friend of mine, and yours, you got to say hello. Knew him from the Santa Clara days. It's sad to see him retire, got a nice condo in Hawaii. And Carol Williams were just the AD and coaches out at Santa Clara, beautiful spot.
And a great resource for Johnny Dawkins as he gets his first head coaching job.
Austin Holland kicks it to Williams, and Williams standing on the sideline. The officials doing a nice job of trying to keep both teams a little more calmer than they have been in the last couple of minutes.
But that kills you, right? Not knowing where you are on the floor.
Yeah. One thing Stanford does not need at this point is mental errors of being outplayed physically.
This kid is really playing good basketball. How about that? Somebody got hit in the mouth there. Williams
sure did.
Just a flailing arm. I don't think it was one of those discards, Fran.
Got a timeout with 11:53 to go in the ballgame. Stanford by 15.
Sports Center right now, Bill Parcells tells ESPN's Chris Mortensen about the Saints coaching vacancy. If the opportunity presents itself, I'll think it over, and clearly in some phase of the process without knowing whether it's going to become a reality. Chapel Hill, North Carolina underclassmen Harrison Barnes, John Henson, and Kendall Marshall all declare for the NBA draft. Coach Roy Williams saying it's a great day for the three youngsters who are taking the step towards their ultimate goal of playing professional basketball. SportsCenter currently on ESPN News. Guys.
Been a lingering discussion about what to do of this last foul as Rodney Williams went down hard after contact from the left arm of Powell.
I think it's a basketball play, but they're so intent now of protecting player, the disarmed player.
I think part of what plays into this call is what happened, is what has happened in the last 10 minutes. Guys getting very physical with each other, but that shouldn't change the call.
Yeah, they're calling it a contact dead ball, which means they must have, did they have the foul on Williams first? Whistle blow, so now it's got to be a dead ball.
After the play.
See, a contact technical foul is a foul that occurs after the ball becomes dead.
So he'll shoot, and then they'll
adjudicate the other end.
Shoot, and then the ball. Again, this is, I think, the reaction this year to making sure nobody gets hurt. And I think next year it will be tempered where it has to be, as you said, off the air, Mike, an intentional hit.
Yeah.
That was obviously, there was no malice involved in that.
No. I mean, the schoolyard, you wouldn't call that, or you wouldn't be back.
That's right. Now, the other thing is going to be interesting to see who shoots the free throw. Because it's a contact dead ball technical, the opposing coach cannot choose one of the four on the floor.
That's why they got a 90% shooter.
That's exactly right. Which is a great little coaching move right there, Bill, right?
Exactly.
And what makes it worse for Minnesota was Williams' fourth personal foul.
Maybe get him going here, too. Dre Collins.
So this is the contact dead ball technical that Dre Collins is shooting. Wow. Saul Smith was just telling Dre Collins from the side, foul through. It was almost like they were shocked he missed it.
Well, he's got the single season record. If he had made 9 free throws tonight without a miss, he would have led the nation in free throw percentage. But he's missed one. He just saw it. He's 2 out of 4 from the free throw line. But he is still going to set that single season record. Turnover here. Stanford's defense has made the difference tonight.
And he went left, but then he had to go back right, and he got caught. And they're just not valuing the ball. And the extraordinary defense, Mike, you're right.
See, I love that help right there. Great help defense on every drive.
This is an open middle they're running now. They were weaving, and now an offensive foul. Oh, my goodness, Austin.
I like the fact that these three officials have just grabbed control of the game, and they're not going to let anything get out of hand.
They just don't want it to get any worse than it has been.
Yeah.
And it's been physical.
That's right.
Certainly at times, very physical. Fouls on Austin Hollins, his third. Here comes full court pressure.
Oh, it works. Bright cutting down. He's got to be the bailout guy. And Randall at the other end, he can't vacate. Did you ever rule one guy had to be behind the ball handler, as an outlet?
And or we also said leave the area and then replace with somebody else. So there's always somebody behind.
Right.
It's a helpless feeling for Powell.
Yeah.
You can't take it back. Yeah. Williams is back in the ball game. Good news for Minnesota. The bad news, they're down by 18. They have been dominated by Stanford's defense.
Oh, goodness.
Here comes Bright. Welch is back.
Nice hustle by Dre. That's making up for a mistake.
You like to see that. A team still hustling like that, down by 18, and they've been dominated here in the second half.
Well, we've seen teams come back. I mean, it's just a matter of just this end of the floor taking care of business, and right now, I believe Johnny Dawkins took time.
Wants a timeout with 10:48 to go. 49-31 Stanford.
ESPN's exclusive presentation of the NIT is brought to you by Fidelity Investments. Turn here. And Jaguar. See the new model year lineup at JaguarUSA.com.
Welcome back to New York, 49-31 Stanford. The NCAA Division I Women's Basketball Championship will continue with the Final Four on Sunday night on ESPN. It starts with the Women's Final Four Special at 6 Eastern, then at 6:30 Eastern, UConn and Notre Dame, then at 8:30 Stanford and Baylor. All games also on ESPN3 and live on WatchESPN.com and the Watch ESPN.
It's not going to be easy, but how about Stanford might be able to hang 2 banners this spring, right?
Pretty nice.
Be pretty good.
Who do you like with the holes? A number of them, I should say. Who do you like?
Well, I saw the big girl in person, Brittany Griner, against Texas A&M. She is unbelievable. She's skilled, Bill.
Right. I've seen her run the floor.
She's not big, not just big, but really skilled.
Right. Yeah, that's the key. She's just not just big.
Yes.
She can play.
And they've got a good nucleus around her. But, you know, they've been in a couple close games. Mm-hmm. Notre Dame. And
they have a good little guard, too.
Yes, Odyssey Sims. Yeah. And actually, UConn was up double figures in the second half in Waco. And they rallied the Bears. And you ever seen Kim Mulkey on the sideline? Oh, she's a good coach.
Is that right?
Oh, she's a good tremendous job. Coach. Yep, absolutely.
She's a pretty good player, too.
She was. Yep.
tough. 51-31. Stanford has amassed a 20-point margin. Coleman.
That's great help.
Really haven't been good attacking the basket either because of this terrific defense. Tough, tough. Not getting much. Closing down passing lanes.
Nothing's open.
Yeah. No.
Nothing.
It's like Bill's wallet.
No, that never opens.
Can Bill's wallet get out on the jump shooter and then close that fast?
It's amazing when your head is taken out. In this case, not Gordon.
Welch got it inside. Ingram would have had to work a long time to get a good look.
You know, Dre not having a great game. Now you got to find other people to do the damage. Looking around, Williams out with the fouls and the injury.
And nobody to create.
Man, good drive, good kick. Bright for three. Got a little swagger about him, doesn't he?
Sure does.
You know, he's from Seattle. Those kids up in Seattle, you know, the Jet Terrys and right. All the Damon Stoudemires, that's who these guys idolize.
Peyton Seaver?
Yeah, Peyton Seaver.
About the same age, but.
No, I bet they played against each other, you know.
A great play, though. Drive everybody, collapse the D, and then just get them organized out there.
There's just nobody right now in Minnesota that can get away from the stifling defense. Armland, way off. And another player's down.
Well, we've talked about this all night, the great help side defense. Take a look right here. Aaron Bright wants to drive. Watch this drive. Watch this right here, Bill. This is good defense. Great help.
Mm.
And then watch the recovery.
Good solid.
I mean, that's
play.
Like shell defense. Yep. You do in practice every day.
Except they got five.
Yeah.
But they've been organized all game long. Great preparation by Johnny and his staff. And the kids have responded.
Minnesota, 3 out of 18 since they hit their last field goal at the 1937 mark. Jeez.
Chubby knows it's a struggle.
This will be a little boost in the arm for the Pac-12, won't it?
Sure will. They beat Colorado twice, this team. It's crazy kind of a year, but I think they've gotten a lot better as this year has progressed, particularly the tournament.
Well, they're regular season champion, the University of Washington, the first of the Big Six conferences ever denied an NCAA bid after winning the regular season, and that really hurt. It hurt them and hurt the whole conference.
And Randall's shown what he's made of, I think. Nice dish.
Well, it's good bounce pass to Coleman.
Trying to step it up, put a little pressure on. You got to score to get the press on. That's been their dilemma.
Wright gets a screen and gets it across the timeline. Well, it's almost time to start working the clock and make sure you're going to leave this building with a trophy. Maybe not quite yet.
You know, Johnny Dawkins worked under Mike as well. He's one of the best at shortening the game.
Randall! Two in a row, Jason Randall from Rock Island, Illinois, the Illinois Gatorade Player of the Year.
Oh, what a freshman year he's had.
Look at the smile, too.
Yeah.
You got to chase him off that line.
And those top 50 guys that we talked about Johnny attracting to the farm. Beautiful up there, isn't it?
Well, New Jersey, if you buy the farm, you're in deep trouble. Out there, it's gorgeous country. Hi, Cotton.
Another good bounce pass, and Ingram, the recipient. It's amazing the way Stanford broke open a close game. It's like somebody flipped a switch, and the defense just became suffocating.
Yeah, you're right. They got down early with the defense and just made it tougher. And here's what you were talking about, Fran.
A lot of experience on the part of these young guys. You know, we haven't said much about Anthony Brown tonight, but talk about a sophomore, 6'4", 6'5", and Bright, Randall, good backcourt.
Well, the guys they lose, Josh Owens, who averages 11.5 points and almost 6 rebounds a game, and Andrew Zimmerman, who's more of a role player at 4 points and 2.5 rebounds, So you've got to replace some size up front, but certainly from a standpoint of depth and backcourt, they've got it going pretty well.
That's right. And the three kids they're bringing in are all up front players, you know, front court guys.
Well, that was close to a 5-second count. Man, had it taken away by Welch, but Welch stepped on the sideline when he did it.
Like to see Minnesota being tough, Fran. And how about your guy Williams, Rodney?
No dunks tonight for Rodney. He's got about 60 on the season, but coming up after this NIT championship, the dunk contest. We'll see him next season, Bill.
In studio, just a reminder, coming up next, it is the State Farm Slam Dunk three-point championships from New Orleans. Good look at Miles Plumlee from Duke. 89 career dunks. He will be involved in the dunk contest tonight. It's coming up next. It's always a fun time from the host of Final Four. Guys?
Ryan, Mike Krzyzewski said Miles Plumlee was the most athletic player on his ball club.
Mm-hmm.
He could really run the floor. 2012 NCAA Men's Final Four starts Saturday on CBS at 6. Louisville against Kentucky for an opportunity to go to the national championship game. For more information, go to NCAA.com.
Unusual that three brothers on the same team when you think of it, huh?
That's right.
I think the Bockhorns at Dayton, and I believe O'Brien's at Villanova.
I like that, the Bockhorns, yeah.
Bucky yeah. Still does the radio.
That's right. Good man.
Bucky's tough late at night, too. Nice entry.
Does he outshine you?
Oh, he's good.
Minnesota has just been shut off by the Stanford defense.
There's nowhere to go, really, yeah. Mike. When you think of it, it's they don't have size, don't have post-up guys. So it really has to be created off the bounce pretty much.
You know, it's a bad mix because Minnesota during the season turns it over almost once every four times.
Mm-hmm.
And these guys at Stanford are forcing 21 turnovers a game in the NIT. So
and look at the pressure on the dribbler too, and then the help. A nice automatic switch.
Even when they get a bucket, they have to use so much of the shot clock to get a decent look.
Great job.
Ingram, good pass. Hollins had it knocked away. Zimmerman, more influential than he looks. Great pass, and man with a layup.
You can see that coming. Got to stay at home in that lane.
This is the time of game, if you're ahead by 25 points, you can basically do whatever you want.
Mm-hmm.
Take some chances, absolutely. Your decisions have been good tonight.
Armwood. Welch, really good outside shooter.
Yeah, spot up like that, he's dead on.
If you're Minnesota right now, just try to cut into it. Try to get down to 10 or 12.
No flex. You run a little of that?
Not really, but I was just. That's nice.
Nice.
But you don't put the flex in for Johnny. Dick Davey.
Oh, sure.
Right? I don't think Coach K ran much flex.
No. If anything, maybe just the one part of it, that bump across the lane. Kentucky does that beautiful for Gilchrist, don't they?
Yeah, they do.
Welch. Zimmerman with a rebound.
Yeah, you know what? When you got this kind of lead, you don't have to. You can run anything.
Well, maybe you had a lot of these. I never did.
As fun as it is on the upside, if you are the team that's down by 24, it is a miserable last 5:24.
My friend's right. As long as they play hard right down the stretch, play with dignity, typical of a Tubby team like this.
Just like that. That's going to be a foul on Bright. That's a great call. Reached out with that arm.
Mm-hmm. Nice double up.
Bright.
Stanford foul on number two on the right. It's fourth the team's eight.
Ralph Sampson, the third. Six straight games he has missed with a sprained knee.
Then you add in Trevor Mbakwe, of course, who was out early in the year, and Mo Williams is the big fellow. Maurice Williams still hurt, so they've been through a lot this year.
Can you imagine having that name and have to live up
to what people expect of you just by seeing what your name is.
Right, right. One of the great players of all time. Williams is out of the game now. Just got in, discarded in the low box area.
Rodney just picked up his fifth, the young man who has had such an exceptional NIT run. And it's not going to end well.
No, not at all. Got untracked.
You know, you look at Rodney Williams and the kind of NIT tournament he had, and had Minnesota played a little better tonight, I think he'd have been a strong candidate for the MVP of this tournament.
Who are you going to give it to now?
I think Bright, the way Bright's played out throughout. You know, I guess did they count it over these two games here or the five? Because Bright had 29 against Illinois State.
Yes, he did.
Well, he's averaged 17 in the tournament, and he shots almost 70% from three-point range.
Yep, that's a March look right there, Bill. Yep. You know, in season, you got to put the balls away tomorrow.
All that effort and the whole season and coming in here with high hopes. Obviously, a very disappointing moment. I would think they pick on these two games, though. What do you think?
Yeah.
Yep. Well, how about this? They're just a pin down. They're doing whatever they want.
And isn't it amazing that kids that shoot the ball with a 24-point lead shoot it in great rhythm and confidence?
Yeah.
Well, there's no pressure on it. Anthony
exactly.
Brown, nice shooter, though. Here comes, look at this. Nobody back.
Run out for Bright. Excellent.
Give him the MVP.
Yeah. Excellent.
So I knew you would go for
the little guy.
Yeah, exactly.
Of course, of course.
Very unselfish play by Aaron Bright.
He's not as quick as Phil Pressey in Missouri, but he's got that kind of presence.
Holland's going to miss.
Sorry, Mike. We're speaking of great years. Late to, and it ends, you know, it's like bang.
Yep.
Just one tough game. And not up to the task.
You got to win the games in that tournament when you play that.
Get by one, right?
Stanford has made 10 of its last 11 shots. That was Anthony Brown, who makes it a 30-point lead.
Anthony Brown had a great summer playing with USA Basketball on the team Paul Hewitt coached. And those experiences really pay off.
Was it Oklahoma you beat? Was that even
Was
it?
Yeah.
I mean, imagine how they felt out in Norman.
That's the beauty of the tournament. We've seen it, right? Norfolk State and Ohio. Look at Ohio. It got John Gross a job, didn't it?
Yes, it did.
Well, you know, here's something interesting, Mike. Stanford went to Spain last summer. They didn't win a game against great talent. It's all paid off here.
Never been to Spain, but I kind of like the music.
Que pasa, Miguel?
We're about 7 minutes away from the State Farm Slam Dunk three-point championships from New Orleans. Good look there at Kenny Gabriel. He's got a shot tonight. We'll see him coming up next. Guys, should be a lot of fun tonight from New Orleans.
Well, you always hope for a close ball game as a broadcaster. If you were in the Garden the last couple of nights, no cigar. 108-86, the Knicks and the Magic tonight. A 30-point game, but we've had a lot of points, if you like that.
If you like defense.
I was just going to say, great defense by Stanford. And it doesn't surprise me at all, knowing who Johnny played for and coached under. That's been the trade, the hallmark of that great Duke program. Now he's brought it west.
Coleman at the line, the young man out of Minneapolis, another freshman. Mr. Basketball in that state. Start collecting guys who have Mr. Basketball in the state they grew up in after the name. You can do all right.
Yeah. You'll be in the hunt.
Unless you recruit in Idaho, but they've got some good players too now.
Yeah.
They have.
Well, you're likely to get most of them, aren't you?
Notice how Fran is careful to denigrate anybody. He might have some career motivations.
I love it up there.
Friday night, ESPN will bring you an NBA doubleheader. It all starts with the Kia NBA Countdown Show at 7:30 Eastern. Then at 8, the Mavericks and the Magic at 10:30. Trailblazers face the Clippers. Andre Hollins has just picked up his fifth, so the two stars will sit on the bench together because Rodney Williams had fouled out previously. Tough night for Hollins, held to 4 points after he had had such a brilliant NIT, averaging 17 points a game coming in. But you've got to credit the Stanford defense with this win. They made the difference.
And they had 33% field goal percentage for Minnesota, outstanding D. And how about 17 assists, too, on those 28 made baskets? That's pretty unselfish play.
Bright's got a great stroke.
You know what I like about this? Johnny Dawkins has got the three seniors out there, and I'm sure they're going to be coming out soon.
Look at this, face the ball, open up. Pretty, huh? Defensively by Bright. All those drills all year long.
And it's the fourth senior, Jack Trotter.
Zimmerman with a follow, couldn't hit it, commits the foul.
And he knows a mistake, Wisconsin kid.
Well, we started with 345. We still got four in the NCAA Final Four. We are going to have one man standing at the end of this night, and it's going to be the Stanford Cardinal. They are going to win their second NIT championship. The first came in 1991, the first for Johnny Dawkins. Two 20-win seasons in his first 4 years at Stanford. Many more to come, you'd have to believe.
Two classy guys, too, on both benches, don't you think?
Oh, absolutely.
Just
couldn't ask for better.
Top of the profession.
Like to see this, really hustling on defense.
Ooh. That was for Rodney Williams, but it was the wrong team.
Exactly. Yep. Rodney's fouled out already.
Yeah, Rodney is seated. He's not going to get that one.
Jared Mann was just trying to set up that dunk contest that follows this game.
He went to the promos, too. I'm very proud of you.
Welch with a runner.
And there's a pretty good three-point shooting contest. Marcus Denman will be in there. In case you're interested.
Yeah. Did he have a great year?
You ought to do the halftime of that three-point shooting, maybe from your hotel room. Now, this is a timeout to, as you mentioned, empty the pines. And look at the hugs and caresses.
They're going to hang the banner, right? And our producer, Kim Belton, who was an outstanding player in the late 70s, a little tear in his eye, Bill, down in the truck, huh?
Oh, absolutely.
That NIT championship that eluded him.
He deserves to be happy. 91, and it was Mike Montgomery against Billy Tubbs as they took on Oklahoma. Adam Keefe powered the Sooners inside, overpowered them, scored 12 points. They had to his 24 in the semifinal against UMass. He was the tournament MVP. Stanford won its first NIT championship, 78-72. You mentioned our producer, Kim Belton. He's still number three all-time in rebounds, number six all-time in points at Stanford.
Well, we have to pass that test to work with him. Numbers, and as you noted, just keep playing. That's all you can do if you're Minnesota.
Sure.
But I had the good fortune of playing in Naples with our team years ago when Kim was there, and they took us to the woodshed. Now they've had some nice teams. Todd Lickey, you mentioned the other night. Well, this is the start of something pretty good, I think, don't you?
Absolutely. Know,
there is one guy out there I want to mention right now, a young man by the name of Andy Brown. He's a 6'7 junior out of Yorba Linda, California. He has had three ACLs in 3 years. Finally got on the court this year. You don't know how happy that kid is just to be able to play basketball.
Mm-hmm. And to be a part of this. It's such an emotional input to being a good team and a winning team, don't you think? And the last guy who we sometimes don't get to see is an integral part of the harmony and the support group that's so necessary to be a champion.
These guys are together for about 8 months when you start the weight training in August and September.
And he'll have the picture of this box score framed in his office when he's the CEO of a major corporation.
Wow. A lot of turnovers, of course. Stanford has been turning people over in the NIT 21 times a game.
He
He's got great eyes. Now, look at those eyes can look not Frank Martin like, but
well, nobody's like Frank Martin.
No, his eyes come down and bang your chest and then go back in.
Coming up after our game, the State Farm College Slam Dunk and three-point championship from New Orleans. Slam dunk contest, Miles Plumlee, you'll see. John Scherna in the three-point contest from Northwestern. That kid had quite a season.
I think Fran taught him the technique on his jumper. Very unorthodox, right?
I did not, but it, you know what?
It works.
It works.
Nice.
Absolutely.
Here's your guy and an assist.
And a block by Coleman. Ingram got the roll. Got Wade Morgan in the ball game. He wears number 20. Ryan number 14 is in. Lemons number 10 is in. Guys that don't get very many minutes. But you know, as a coach, these guys are invaluable at practice. Oh,
absolutely. Every day they scout team, right?
Absolutely. They don't do the offense of the other team better than most people. You mentioned Wade out there. A Del Barton kid, which is where our son went.
Oh.
Terrific school out in the Morristown area.
These kids usually end up at places like Stanford.
Yeah, they do a great job, no question about it.
Welch, good pass inside, but lost it on the way up. Ingram couldn't get a good grip on the ball and hit the deck.
Nastich with a good rebound right there. Down on the ground. You saw those highlights of the 91 NIT. See Billy Tubbs. He got ejected in the first half of that game. And our good friend Josephine Trainer made sure he had some beverages in the locker room until the game ended.
Billy was quite a guy. Blake told a great story about his offensive might at this Tuesday.
Hey. Andy Brown. Way to go, young man. You blow out a knee three times in 3 years, you deserve to play and deserve a chance to score.
They deserve a little applause by your teammates as well.
Yes, sir.
Tubby just getting his guy in.
How about scoring at Madison Square Garden? Something he can tell his grandkids.
For sure.
When he's retired from that, from that
CEO
company.
Job?
Yeah. At 40.
Inside a minute to go. Coleman.
Oh,
nice little scoop.
Look at
that. Hey, you got to hand it to Minnesota. Playing hard right down to the end.
That's the way. That's Tubby style. Refs aren't going to call anything right now.
No.
They got to
protect yourself. Coleman got a basket. This is a Lemon out of Carmichael, California.
It's got to be a good feeling on the one side.
Now the fans come to their feet. Josh Owens will end his career at Stanford with an NIT championship. The Cardinal wins its 26th game and the NIT title. Congratulations to Stanford. They win it going away. Now, we send you to New Orleans.